before the video starts,
today's shoutout winner goes to Kyle Mack.
If you guys want a chance to win a shoutout in the next video, drop a like and a comment down below, subscribe with notifications on, and I will pick somebody randomly that will be shouted out in my next video. I hope you guys enjoy.
Yo, what's going on, guys? Satuki here, and holy moly, guys. I don't know what's been happening. There has been so much news this week, and if it isn't obvious already, I yet again have another juicy video for you guys. But firstly, let's see how many likes we can break on this video. Let's shoot for 7 likes on this video, and you know, guys, let's try to get 5 new subscribers. So if you are watching this and you are not subscribed, you know, be sure to subscribe, you know. But anyways, our first story is mind-boggling. I can't even comprehend it. As you guys already know, Bugha won the Fortnite World Cup, he was the solo champion, and he won $3 million, right? But unfortunately, this is not true, and this is very sad. This Twitter account tweeted out saying, "The state of New York / federal government will collect $1.5 million in taxes from 16-year-old Fortnite World Cup solo champion Bugha. He will take home just $1.5 million out of the $3 million he earned." Damn, man, that's actually very, very, very unfortunate. So basically, Bugha is gonna be getting taxed, and he only gets to keep half of the money he earned because of the government taxing him. But don't get me wrong, guys, $1.5 million is still a lot, but it's nowhere compared to $3 million. And not only that, guys, Sentinels, which is the team Bugha plays for, is also getting a cut from his money. Slasher tweeted out saying, "I spoke to CNN's Shannon Lyo on esports organizations taking relatively large cuts of prize money, 20%, from inexperienced Fortnite players, including Sentinels, getting $600,000 from Bugha's World Cup win." So holy, guys, absolutely biblical. Not only is Bugha getting taxed, but Sentinels, which is the team he plays for, is also getting some of Bugha's prize money too. And that only leaves Bugha with 900 grand. Kiri posted a pretty funny video about this situation, and just watch it, guys.
Oh my god, I can't believe I won 3 mil. I need to go to the bank.
Howdy, partner.
I would like to deposit 3 mil.
Sure, give me 1 second. I will be taking this.
What the?
So damn, guys, I still can't even comprehend it. Bugha just got scammed. Like, just imagine, you win $3 million, life-changing money, you get taxed by the government, Donald Trump takes your money, your gaming team takes some money, and then you're left with under $1 million. If I was Bugha, I would be devastated. But let me know what you guys think of this whole situation. Drop a comment below. Our next story is coming from Ghost X. Now, this one really isn't that important, however, I do know that there are a few people out there who feel this way about X too. But anyways, this all started when Ghost Shaw tweeted out a picture of X blocking him on Twitter, but it was just a joke, because after a few minutes, Shaw deleted the tweet, and then after that, guys, a guy named NV replied to Shaw's tweet by saying, "X has changed. I feel like he grinded just to get money and be respected. All he posts is his car, money being wasted on parts. I miss the old X who constantly grinded. Even when he was in a closet, he was motivated." And this reply got 120 likes, so it does seem like people are agreeing with NV and what he just said about X. And then, guys, the juicy part. Ghost X saw Envy's reply and said this on Twitter, "I didn't quote unquote change. I'm literally just trying to explore my life while I can. I couldn't explore back then when I grinded because I was too broke. Now I grinded for where I am, so I want to be able to explore. I don't understand what is wrong with you guys. Holy poop, I earned it." So you know, guys, X does have a really good point here. He just wants to enjoy life while he is young. He already put in the hard work back then, you know. But I also see it from the other side. Like, if X is your favorite YouTuber and he's not uploading or grinding, I completely understand why his viewers will be mad. While Ghost X is showing off his cars and not grinding as his fans want him to. And speaking of his cars, guys, I'm actually very happy for X. If you guys don't know, X is 17 years old and he has accomplished so much. As such a young age, a couple weeks ago, he tweeted out saying, "My happiness. Can't thank you guys enough. I love you guys. Thank you so much for getting me this car. Without you guys, I don't know where I would be right now. Love you." And holy, guys, just take a look at his car. It is very, very nice, guys. And the fact that X is driving that at the age of 17 just really goes to show how hard X has grinded, you know. But nonetheless, hopefully X can get back on the grind and start uploading to YouTube again. And right when I say that, Ghost X tweeted out saying, "No uploads upload today. Not in the mood anymore. Sorry. So you know what, guys? Hashtag get X back on the grind. Our next story is shocking. Now, just a little backstory on this. During the Fortnite World Cup, Nirox and Aqua were the duo champions, and they won $3 million, $1.5 million for each, before taxes and all that. But anyways, on paper, I think it is safe to say that Nirox and Aqua are a great duo. It seems like they have really good chemistry together, and that basically, they work really well together, you know? But truth be told, Nirox and Aqua are no longer a duo, guys. Aqua posted a statement on Twitter, and this is what he had to say regarding Aqua not dueling with Nirox anymore. He says, "I started this whole thing wrong, and never meant to send hate to Nirox or anyone. Nirox and I have been playing for a long time, and we won the World Cup, yes, but that doesn't mean we are the best duo, or I could improve more of someone else. I feel like Stompy and I fit each other better, and Nirox and I have been talking about this for longer as well. Sorry for the quote-unquote beef on Twitter. I never meant to hurt anyone. Nirox and I are friends, and I wish him the best of luck in the future." So crazy stuff, right? Somebody in the reply said, "This is the most brain-dead thing I've ever seen. You guys won $3 million together and got first place out of everyone in the entire world. And you think you can do quote-unquote better. You can't do better if you got first. Hello? Question mark." And many people have the same opinion, including me, kinda. If something isn't broken, don't fix it. If you know what I mean, you know. That's all I'm gonna say. And as you guys heard, Aqua's new duo is Stompy. And currently, at the time I'm making this video, Nirox has yet to announce his new duo. But let me know what you guys think of this whole situation, and who Nirox's new duo should be, you know. Our next story is actually pretty cool. This one is coming from FaZe Dubs' dad. Yes, you guys heard that right. FaZe Dubs' dad. If you guys don't know who Dubs is, well, basically, he's a professional Fortnite player for FaZe, and holy guys. FaZe Dubs' dad ended up getting a FaZe tattoo. The official FaZe Clan Instagram posted the picture and said, "Supported his son's FaZe Dubs' journey all the way through the World Cup, and now has it on him for life. Dubs' dad is a real one." And you know what, guys? I think this is a great thing. It really shows how supportive Dubs' parents are, and that many parents are opening up to the esports and gaming community, and that they are supporting it. But yeah, the tattoo does look really nice. I know Banks, Rain, Temper, Tico, and a few other members in FaZe also have the FaZe logo tattoo on them. But anyways, our next story is absolutely biblical. And this one is actually pretty biblical. People are gonna talk about this topic for years to come. So yes, this is an appropriate time to use the word biblical. This one is coming from Ninja. And oh my god, guys. Today, Ninja completely quit streaming on Twitch. He is 100% done with Twitch.tv. And he moved over to Mixer. Yes, guys, you heard that right. Ninja left Twitch and moved to Mixer full-time. And I'm sure this was a hard decision for Ninja, because if you guys don't know, Ninja is literally the biggest channel on Twitch. So many people watch him, and he has broken so many records. As you guys already know, last year Ninja was streaming with Drake, and I'm also sure that Mixer probably offered Ninja a lot of money. I've heard rumors like $10 million a year, $100 million a year. Nobody really knows. And the funny part is, when Ninja left Twitch, the people over at Twitch removed Ninja's checkmark. They removed him from the partner program and his sub button. And you can't really blame them, because in a way, you know, Ninja did betray Twitch, and he just completely abandoned the ship, if you know what I mean. Mr. Beast tweeted out saying, "Guess it's time to donate to Mixer streamers." And this guy tweeted out saying, "Wow, the power of Ninja. He announced the switch to streaming on Atwatch Mixer, and it's number one in the App Store right now." So insane, right? But you know, guys, I'm keen for the future. We never know. Mixer might be the next big streaming platform. So let's keep our eyes peeled. Before we move on, I want to see who made it this far into the video. So if you are here this right now, comment down below right now and tell me something you don't like about Fortnite Season 10. I just want to see who's a real one and who actually watches my videos, you know. And I just want to give another shout out to a few more people. So shout out to 7ev, Dark Ghost, Popular Chance, Tipsy, and YoFlix for watching my videos and for being a part of the Juicy Gang. But now back to the good stuff. Our next story is pretty insane, guys. This one has to do with FaZeWay. Now, a few days ago, AggroRansom tweeted out saying, "I swear the only non-creative warriors are Innocence and Assault. They dropping 30 bumps and going creative and still keep up with FaZeWay. What's your excuse?" So damn, guys. Basically, Ransom is saying that FaZeWay plays creative 24/7, whereas Innocence and Assault don't play creative as much as FaZeWay does, and they still keep up with him. And he's basically saying that Sway isn't really that good for the amount of time he plays, you know. And then, guys, FaZeWay replies with, "They don't keep up." Then AggroRansom replies to Sway by saying, "Didn't you 1v1 Assault? And the score was 10-9. So damn, guys, it was a pretty close match." Then Innocence replied with, "10-6. You beat me, then I beat you 10-2 and 5-3 on stream." Then Sway replied with, Then I beat you 20-4 and pickaxed you like 10 times. Shaw was there. Then Innocent said, "At Shaw, do you remember any of this? I think he's tripping." And then Ghost Shaw says something very biblical. He replies with, "I have short-term memory loss, but I remember the size of your peepee." Then Faithful replies with, "You kept saying, why you keep building, bro? What the F? Shoot your gun." Then Innocent says, "Liar." And then Sway says, "Lamau, now you remember." But honestly, saying Innocent and Assault are non-creative warriors and that they still keep up with Faceway is a pretty bold statement, you know. But let me know what you guys think. Who do you think the best creative warrior is from Innocence, Assault, and Faceway? Out of those three, who do you think the best one is? Our last story is also pretty massive, guys. This one is coming from FaZe Clan. As you guys already know, Tfue tried to scuba his way out of FaZe, and you guys know that whole situation when Tfue was suing FaZe, but that is all old news. However, guys, FaZe Clan is actually gonna be suing Tfue back. And I'm gonna be honest, I saw this coming, because if you guys don't know, Tfue did breach his contract with FaZe. TMZ made an article about this, and it goes on to say, "The powerful FaZe Clan gaming team is suing its most famous member, Tfue, claiming the 21-year-old has betrayed the team and damaged the brand by trying to weasel his way out of their contract." But now, FaZe Clan is firing back in a lawsuit filed in federal court in New York, essentially saying, "Boohoo, you signed the contract and need to live up to it." Though a rookie athlete, Tfue was an adult when he signed the contract. FaZe says, adding, "An initial rookie contract is a risk that the organization takes. Most young players, young careers never take off." In fact, FaZe Clan says they believe Tfue has made more than $20 million in earnings since joining FaZe Clan in April of 2018, and he's only forked over 60 grand. FaZe says, "Tfue was just your average skilled gamer when they found him, and they transformed him into a bankable gaming pro." FaZe says the deal they have in place of Tfue locks him up until 2021, and the fact he's trying to build is complete BS. FaZe says they recognized Tfue was a star, and offered significant bonuses along the way, including an offer to increase his revenue shares in the company substantially. They also claim they offered Tfue a 7-figure salary, but Tfue refused to play the ball. Instead, FaZe claims Tfue trashed the company publicly, violating a non-disparagement clause in his contract. Now, FaZe is suing for their share of Tfue's earnings, and to shut him up from divulging confidential information about the clan. So pretty crazy stuff, right? And also, guys, it's not FaZe Banks, Temper, Rain, or any of those big guys in FaZe we know personally going out of their way to sue Tfue. All of those guys can't be bothered with all this business stuff. It is the people behind the scenes in FaZe suing Tfue, because I'm sure still, FaZe Banks still loves Tfue. So you know, I'm sure Banks isn't going out of his way to sue Tfue, but it is still pretty biblical. And let me know what you guys think of all of this. Do you guys think Tfue's team's gonna win, or do you think FaZe Clan is gonna win the lawsuit? Drop a comment below.
But that's all the news for today, guys. If you guys happen to enjoy the video, drop a like and a comment. And if you want to be kept updated with everything that happens, make sure to subscribe with notifications on. Okay, peace.